We want to factor and solve the given quadratic equations. The most important thing to remember when solving a quadratic equation by factoring is to not forget the first step in factoring, which is to factor out the greatest common factor. In our first example, we have 3x squared plus 15x plus 18 equals 0. So it's important to recognize in this problem that 3 is the greatest common factor of these three terms, so the first step is to factor the 3 out. And by doing this, it's going to make it a much easier factoring problem. If we factor out 3, we'd be left with x squared plus 5x plus 6 equals 0. And then we can factor the trinomial factor, as we normally would, with the leading coefficient of 1. So we'd have this extra factor of 3, and then if this does factor, it'll factor into two binomial factors. And because the leading coefficient is 1, it makes it a lot easier to factor. The factors of x squared go in the first positions. And now we want the factors of positive 6 that add to positive 5. Well, 3 times 2 is equal to positive 6, and 3 plus 2 is equal to positive 5. Therefore, one binomial factor is going to be x plus 3, and one of the factors will be x plus 2. So now that we have it in factored form, and this product is equal to 0, the factor of x plus 3 must equal 0, or the factor of x plus 2 must equal 0. So now if we solve this equation for x, we would have x equals negative 3 by subtracting 3 on both sides. And here we would subtract 2 on both sides for a solution of x equals negative 2. So notice how if we missed this common factor of 3, it would make factoring this much more difficult. Looking at our second example, we have 8x squared minus 72x plus 162 equals 0. Again, the first step is to look for common factors. It would be nice if 8 was a common factor, but 8 does not divide evenly into 162. So I believe our only common factor here is 2. Let's start by factoring out a 2 and see what we have left. Factor 2 out, we'll be left with 4x squared minus 36x, this will be plus 81. Equals 0. Now even though this trinomial factor here does not have a leading coefficient of 1, notice how the first term is a perfect square, and so is the third term. So let's try factoring this as a perfect square trinomial. So we'll still have this extra factor of 2, and then we'll have two binomial factors. And because the first term is a perfect square, we'll use the factors of 2x and 2x for 4x squared. And then since 81 is a perfect square, we'll use the factors of 9 and 9, and then we'll use the sign of the middle term, so we'll make both of these minus. Now to make sure this actually works, we'll check the sum of the inner and outer product to make sure that we have negative 36x. The inner product is negative 18x, the outer product is negative 18x as well, which does give us negative 36x. So this is factored correctly. So notice how what looked like a pretty challenging factoring problem became much more manageable once we factored out the greatest common factor of 2. And we can rewrite this one more time since we do have two factors of 2x minus 9. We could write this as 2 times the quantity 2x minus 9 squared raised to the second equals 0. Now this is only going to equal 0 when the factor of 2x minus 9 equals 0. So we would add 9 to both sides. So we'd have 2x equals 9, divide both sides by 2. So we have one solution, it's x equals 9 halves. And we mentioned before that since we did have two factors of 2x minus 9, we can say that the solution has a multiplicity of 2, or that it's a double zero or double root. We'll take a look at some more examples in the next video.